Afternoon countdown is everywhere. It's a very relaxed studio today.
We've all had a good weekend.
Is that what it is? Yeah. You don't have the Monday feeling, though. You don't feel.
No, I've always liked Mondays.
Yeah. You look kind of very.
But then again, I like numbers, so that doesn't say very much, does it, really?
Do you like rainy Mondays?
No, I don't like rain.
There's a song called "Rainy Days and Mondays Get Me Down," isn't there?
Yeah.
Yeah, somewhere along. Anyway, we the Carpenters, was it? I think it might
was
be
it
a carpenter? Yeah. There's an email here from a guy called Brian Kendrick, and I'm surprised that this comes from a guy. I would have thought a lady would have sent this one in, and it's self-explanatory. 11 people were hanging on a rope under a helicopter.
Yeah.
10 men and one woman. The rope was not strong enough to carry them all, so they decided one had got to leave, otherwise they were all going to fall off. They weren't able to name that person until the woman gave a very touching speech. She said that she would voluntarily let go of the rope because, as a woman, she was used to giving up everything for her husband and kids or for men in general and was used to making sacrifices with little in return.
Aww.
As soon as she finished her speech, all the men started clapping their hands. She's no fool, what? All right, let's get to the people of matter here, our players. Now, Tim is here for the 7th time, so he's going to get a bit itchy and twitchy now because he's getting near that Octochamp stage. He's been getting 196, I think was his last one on Friday, and I'm coming apart here. Right, now, Ross is playing. Ross Rochester, and she's from Staffordshire. She's married with 2 children, James and Harry. And it says you're a mean pool player. Are you? Good?
I think so.
She's been playing for a local team called the Jades for over 4 years. Now, his is interesting, because I've just seen this. Roz's dad was in a group called the Jackpots, right, who supported Des O'Connor. I don't know what they mean by supported. Help me up, probably. in the early 60s at West Bromwich Town Hall.
Apparently so, yeah. My mum told me today before I came in. So,
right? Yeah. Were they a band then?
They were a band, yeah. My dad was the pianist.
OK. Oh, well, give him my best wishes.
I will.
Find out how I went that night. More important, find out you two are going to go today and play today. That's Roz and that's Tim playing.
Well, we've known our guest in Dictionary Corner for 25 years as one of the nation's most favoured news anchors, but his career in journalism goes back, years before then. He started his career on the Surrey Mirror and then switched to Fleet Street on the Daily Tory Graph, Daily Telegraph and the Financial Times. Get you, aren't you, posh? Yeah. So, sitting alongside our dictionary darling, Susie Dent, please give a gorgeous welcome for Nicholas Owen. What do you do on the FT? Because that's my favourite paper, the FT.
Oh, is it? Well, numbers, of course.
Numbers, aren't they?
Yes, yes. Well, yes, I was all sorts of things. I was the financial reporter, like many people. I wrote the diary column, which is interesting, because it means I could go and ask businessmen all the sort of questions that no one else asked
them. The cheeky questions.
The cheeky questions, actually. Lovely.
Did you enjoy that?
Yeah, I did. I had a wonderful time. Terrific time. Yeah, yeah.
Wonderful.
Right, I'm going to start asking some questions now, but more of numbers and words. And we're going to start the game with Tim, fingers crossed, for his 7th game in the trot now. And letters on the board, please.
Consonant.
A consonant, Tim. D.
Consonant.
T.
Consonant.
Q.
Vowel.
I.
Vowel.
O.
Vowel.
E.
Consonant.
S.
Consonant.
C.
Vowel.
And a vowel, thank you. And A.
And here's the clock. There, Tim?
7.
7. And Roz?
6.
6. Right. What's your 6?
Cadets.
Cadets. And the 7?
Coasted.
Coasted. Right.
Very good.
Well, there you are. After his usual good start. What's happening in the corner? What do we have?
And we can't do better than 7, but we have got dacoits, which has been talking about there, which is a curious one.
Yes, we were talking about hashashins the other day, and these are armed robbers in India or Burma.
Are they?
Yeah.
Okay, dacoits.
Bit of a favourite countdown word, that
yes,
one.
Yes, it is. Yes,
right, 7 start for Tim there. Roz, you get your first chance now to be part of the game. Put some letters up there, please.
Okay, hi, Carol. I'll start with a consonant, please.
You start with a consonant, thank you. Young lady. T.
And a vowel.
U.
And a vowel.
I.
A consonant.
R.
And consonant.
R.
And a vowel.
E.
A consonant.
S.
And another.
Another consonant. N.
And a vowel, please.
And O.
And here's the clock. Start, Roz?
8.
8. That's not a bad start. And Tim?
7.
7. Right, what's your 7?
Rustier.
Rustier. Yep. And the 8?
Routines.
Routines. I think that's...
We've got it. Fantastic. Well done, you.
Good. Well, that's a nice start there for Roz, puts her 1 point in front. And what have we got over in the corner?
No, we can't do better than that.
Bit gobsmacked there.
Yeah, we're trailing a bit. Yeah.
Very good.
You put them definitely in their corner at that time. Right, as we say, a nice 8 letter there gives you the lead. Right, Tim, your letters, please.
Consonant, please.
Thank you, Tim. J.
Consonant.
B.
Consonant.
S.
Vowel.
A.
Vowel.
I.
Vowel.
A.
Consonant.
R.
Consonant.
D.
Vowel.
And E.
Here's another clock. Tim, what do you have?
7.
7 this time. And Roz?
6.
6. Hey, up and down, you two. What's your 6?
Rabies.
Rabies.
And braised.
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 Okey-doke. Braised, that's fine.
Yeah.
And the corner will offer what?
Yeah. 7 for braised, obviously. And we have another 7. Airbase.
Airbase.
Another one.
Yeah. All one word. Mm-hmm. Okey-doke. Well, let's swing it up and down, as I say. Tim's got 14 this time, and Roz's got 8. And Roz, once again, will be putting some letters up there on the board for us.
Consonant, please.
Thanks, Roz. P.
And a vowel.
A.
And a vowel.
E.
A consonant.
F.
A consonant.
L.
And a vowel.
I.
A consonant.
C.
Consonant.
Y.
And a vowel.
And A.
And here's a clock.
Five.
Just the 5, and Tim?
6.
6. And what's the 5?
Place.
Place, and the 6?
Place with an I.
Place with a...
I. Oh. P-L-A-I-C-E.
A fish, yes. There you are. Drive you crazy, wouldn't it? What you got over there? Yeah.
We've got a couple of sevens here. Pacify.
Yeah.
And sixes, actually.
They're sixes. Sixes. Yeah. I'm sorry, I can't count. I can't. It's on the wrong programme. And Palace. Both of them six, aren't they?
Yes. Yeah,
Palace not you'd know about. You'd know about Palace.
And there is another one, Des, which is slightly more obscure. It's an anatomical term. And it's the plural of something called a plica, P-L-I-C-A. You can put an E on it for plicae, and they're folds or ridges of tissue in the body.
Plico. I didn't know that. Right. Okay, no. 20 for Tim, 8 for Roz. We're going to the numbers board, and Tim is going to call out some instructions to Carol.
One from the top and five from anywhere.
OK, thank you, Tim. Let's see if Roz likes the numbers. OK, here we go. 7 and 4, 9 and 10, 2 and 25, with a target of 6, 8, 8.
Here's that clock. Tim, what have we got? 6, 8, 8?
I think I got 6, 8, 8, yeah.
You think you have, yeah. Okay.
Yeah, 6, 8, 8.
So put your pen down.
Sorry.
No, it's all right. And you got 6, 8, 8?
Yes.
Right, ladies first, I think.
Okay. 7 times 4 is 28.
7 multiplied by the 4 gives you 28.
Times by the 25
gives you 700.
And take away the 10 and the 2.
Yeah, beautifully done, young lady. 6, 8, 8.
6, 8, 8. And Tim?
Same way.
Pardon?
The same way.
Will you show it?
Sorry, sorry.
Let's have a look here. 74. Right, here we are.
That's it? Yeah.
That both?
Yes.
Both
yes.
Correct?
Yeah, both correct.
And they both got the points. So, it's a good game going on here, 30 playing 18. I think it'll get tighter than that as we go along. And we say once again, Nicholas, what are you going to talk about today?
Well, today... There's a charming man that I met the other day. His title, that most people would recognise the title, if not the man, is Black Rod. Now, his job at the state opening of Parliament, you know, when the Queen comes along to give the speech and all the MPs have to go to the House of Lords to hear it, Black Rod is the guy dressed in very fancy old-fashioned gear who goes along with a great big stick in his hand, bangs on the door to summon the MPs through. But very few people know his name. Well, the current Black Rod is a man called Sir Michael Wilcox. He's a lovely fellow, former army general. And you wouldn't think he was a general in the army at any stage, because he's a very tiny guy, really short fella, a man just about over 5 foot. And he told this wonderful tale of how he was in Bosnia, when there was a lot of trouble in the Balkans. And he had to go and see one of the generals of the Serbian army. And this guy had a reputation of being a really nasty piece of work. But General Sir Michael Wilcox went in there, only a little fellow, and he thought, right, I'm a bit nervous with this bloke, but I'm going to lay down the law. And he marched into this chap's office, and the chap got up from behind his desk, and he was a huge man, and little Michael Wilcox came and said, now look here, General. And Wilcox sat down and began banging the table, telling this chap what for. His men had been behaving badly, they'd been doing all sorts of terrible things, and he, Michael Wilcox, I'm not prepared to put up with it, and how dare you? No, don't you say a word, he said to the Serb general. You just listen to me, I'm going to tell you what for. And this chap was all looking at him. And Wilcox then said, how dare you do this, and I don't want this to happen again, and that's it, and I don't want to hear any more about it. He jumped out of his chair, turned round, dashed out of the room, opened the door, straight in the broom cupboard. Went straight in the broom cupboard, got in there, opened the door, came straight out again and said, just checking that no one was listening in. And out he went.
Something from a Blackadder sketch.
It does. Yeah. He's a complete charmer, Michael Wilcox, I have to tell him.
Right, we turn to a tea time teaser here. The word is wrap suits, and that's S-U-I-T-S. Wrap suits, and the clue, it's above my lady's chamber. It's above my lady's chamber.
Thank you.
That word was rap suits, rap suits. It's above my lady's chamber, and the answer was upstairs.
Right. Now, here's the thing.
Here's the thing.
We were going through, weren't we, the poet, the nursery rhyme that we thought it was, and Nick said, upstairs, downstairs, and we're going, oh, we still don't know what the answer is. And Ross is going, upstairs! It's upstairs. But what's the nursery rhyme?
Goosey, goosey gander.
Oh, goosey, goosey gander.
Right, let's get on with the game again. 30, the lead there, 18, Ros, and Ros is going to put some letters on our board.
Okay, start with a consonant, please.
S.
And a vowel.
E.
And a consonant.
T.
And another.
R.
And a vowel.
O.
And another vowel.
And A.
A consonant.
M. Mm-mm.
And another.
P.
And a vowel.
And a vowel. Thank you very much, Ross. That's E.
And here's a clock.
Eight.
Ah, you save them, then you come out with these eights. And Tim?
Seven.
Seven. Right, let's have the seven.
Stamper.
And the eight?
Operates.
Operates. Well done. Excellent. Oh,
well done.
Excellent. Right, I thought we've got a game going to happen here. 30 playing 26, so it's anybody's at the moment. What have we got from the corner?
Same, no, operates was operates. The best we could do as well.
Good word.
Well done.
OK, as I say, just a four-point lead now for Tim, and Tim's going to see what he can do about that with this set of letters. There you go, Tim.
Consonant.
S.
Consonant.
N.
Consonant.
S.
Vowel.
U.
Vowel.
I.
Vowel.
E.
Consonant.
G.
Consonant.
B.
Vowel.
And I.
And here's the clock. Tim, what this time?
Six.
Six. Ros?
Six.
Six. Let's have your six.
Begins.
Begins?
Binges.
Binges. Right. They're both fine. And the corner, what have we got there?
We think we can do one better. Seven. Yes. That we bussing.
Bussing.
Mm. Yes. They were bussing the fans into the stadium, for example.
That's right, yeah.
Yeah.
Right, 36 playing 32, and it's Ros's turn this time with the letters.
Consonant, please.
Thank you, Ros. N.
And another?
N.
And another?
P.
And a vowel?
E.
And another vowel?
A.
And a third?
O.
A consonant?
S.
A consonant?
N.
And another vowel?
Three N's. And U.
Right, here's the clock. What do you make of that lot, Ross?
Five.
Yeah, difficult. Tim?
Five.
Five. Let's have your five, Tim.
Opens.
Opens. Was it?
Yeah.
Opens. And Ross?
Nouns.
Nouns. Right.
Now, one of that sort? Peons, is it?
Peons, that's actually from Latin, originally. So it's P-A-E-O-N-S. Yeah. It's there for six, and just put it on the pen cam there. They're metrical feet of one long syllable and three short syllables in any order.
They're three long
peons. They're metrical feet, basically.
Metrical feet?
Yes. Feet of a poem or music.
Nothing to do with Mexicans.
No. Nice idea, though. I like that.
I was trying.
You were trying. 41 for Tim, 37 for Ross. Right, so Tim, give us some letters, please.
Consonant.
Take us away from all this, Tim. Z. Oh.
Consonant.
T.
Vowel.
E.
Vowel.
A.
Vowel.
E.
Consonant.
T.
Consonant.
G.
Consonant.
T. Good.
Vowel.
We really are going in for the trebles, aren't we, this time around? O.
Right, here's a clock. Good luck. What do you have there, Tim?
Seven.
Seven? That's good. And Rose?
Five.
Five. Let's have the five.
Oh, sorry. Gates.
Gates?
Gates, yeah.
Yep. And the?
Gazette.
Gazette. Excellent.
You're saying gates with an the plural of gate. Yeah.
G-A-T-E-S.
There's no S in the selection. As I said.
It doesn't matter. You're a loser on that one anyway. What are we doing in the corner?
No, we got Gazette as well. But I was interested, just whispering to Susie, what the origin of the word Gazette is.
I looked it up. It's fascinating, actually. It comes from French, via French, from the Italian. And it was originally Venetian, Gazzetta della Novita, which is a half penny worth of news, because the news sheet sold for a Gazzetta, which was a Venetian coin of a very small amount. Oh. Interesting.
Right, Susie, we're going to turn to you and your origins of words or phrases.
My origins of words.
What are you doing, a word or a phrase today?
Well, I was going to do two words that are linked, thanks to this wonderful book, Words of a Feather, because I just find them fascinating that the etymology at one time was very similar and then the words took off in completely different directions. And I was going to look at words that begin with acro, like acronym and acrobat. And the acro is actually meaning in Greek, comes from Greek akros, which meant pointed or sharp. And metaphorically, it took on the sense, probably from mountaintops, of being quite high. So actually people who have acrophobia have a terrifying fear of heights. And then acrobat's third syllable, the bat, is also Greek, and it means to walk. So people were walking on a high rope. But what was fascinating is acronym. You know, an acronym is basically a word that's made up of the first letters of successive words, like scuba diving, for example, is self-contained underwater breathing apparatus. And the acronym, the acro bit, comes from the point of it. If you imagine an arrow pointing to the front of a word, it's taking the very front of each word. And that's why acronym is linked, surprisingly, to acrobat.
Mm. Where does Acropolis come in this?
That means Acropolis is the summit of a city. So acro is the top, again like a mountain, and polis means a city.
Interesting. All very interesting stuff.
She knows, you know.
She does know. Right, it's numbers time. Carol awaits the... whose choice is it? I think it's yours, isn't it?
Inverted T, please.
I'm inverted T. Thank you, Roz. Let's see what we've got this time around. 4 and 10, 2 and 5, 6 and 100. And a target of 669.
Here's that clock. Six, six, nine, Roz. What do we do?
Yes, 669.
You got that? And Tim?
669.
You think you've got that? Tim, you go first.
100 plus 10 is 110.
Yes. 100 plus 10, yep.
Times 6.
660.
Plus 5, plus 4.
Beautifully done, Tim. Yep, 10 points. Good ones.
And Rod, I had a feeling you were going to pass that to me. Yep, that's correct. Both of them got the points.
Lovely.
Both of them got the points. No, 58-47, still a tight game. Here is a little tea time teaser. Abort Day, that's A-B-O-R-T-D-A-Y, all one word, Abort Day. And the clue, it's where Howard had his way. It's where Howard had his way. The word is abort day, and the clue, it's where Howard had his way, and the answer, boatyard.
Yeah, it was a funny clue, that one.
It was an odd one.
Now, we've been up in Barney over here, because I was saying Mexicans and laughing at Nick, and being the word hound that he is.
I found it. It is, I was sort of right. Remember, I think the word we had was P-A-E-O-N,
correct,
wasn't it?
Yes.
And that turned out to be something terribly contradictory to do with metric systems. But this dictionary here, the proper one, says here, P-E-O-N, peon, a Spanish-American day labourer or unskilled farm worker. Is that Mexico or is that Mexico?
You rest your case. Right, let's get back to this game here. It's a good game. 58 playing 47. Could swing either way. And Tim is going to see what he can do, keeping it his way. Letters, please, Tim.
Consonant, please.
Thank you, Tim. R.
Consonant.
L.
Consonant.
M.
Vowel.
A.
Vowel.
E.
Vowel.
I.
Consonant.
S.
Consonant.
N.
Vowel.
And I.
Right, here's a clock. Right, Tim, what do you have?
Eight.
Eight. Oh, ouch. And
seven.
And seven. Yeah, I thought seven would have just about done it there. What's the seven?
Similar.
Similar. And the eight?
Minerals.
Minerals. Is that right? Yes.
Yeah,
minerals
excellent.
Is excellent.
Very well done.
Right, and the corner has what?
No, we will have minerals as well. But you remember the conversation you and I had last week about railways and trains? And
yes.
Railmen is
railmen.
Yes, it is railmen.
Yeah. Not railway men, railmen.
A railman. American term, really.
Yeah. Yeah. Right, 66 playing 47, still not impossible, Rod, so stay punching. If you'll put some letters up there on the board, please.
I'll start with a vowel, please.
Thank you, Ross. O.
Consonant.
R.
And the consonant?
T.
And a vowel?
A.
And a vowel?
U.
The consonant?
H.
Consonant?
R.
Another consonant?
T.
And another vowel?
And another vowel, thank you, Ros. And E.
And here's one more clock. Luck there, Ros?
Six.
Six, Tim?
Six.
Six. Let's go with your six, Tim.
Hotter.
Hotter. And Ros?
Throat.
Throat. Hotter and throat. And in the corner?
We've got a seven here. Torture.
Torture. Mm. Okey-doke. Right. We're going to go back to the letters again as we start nearing the nitty-gritty here, 7253. Tim, would you be so kind as to put some letters up there, please?
Consonant.
Thank you, Tim. L.
Consonant.
P.
Consonant.
Des has had a few of those. X.
Consonant.
H.
Vowel.
A.
Vowel.
E.
Vowel.
A.
Consonant.
D.
Vowel.
And O.
And here's that clock. Tim, what do you have there?
Five.
Five. And Ross?
Six.
Six. Let's have the five.
Ahead.
Ahead. And the six?
Pedalo.
Pedalo, yeah.
Well done, yeah.
Well done, very good.
Right, what have you got from the corner?
I think we've got,
yes, haloed.
Haloed, oh yes, of
yes.
course, haloed.
Haloed angel, it's the adjective, wearing a halo.
Oh, you are haloed if you wear one. Oh, well, interesting. Yeah. Right, let's pull back on the scores there. Back up to 59 points. And we go to the numbers board. So, Roz?
A 1-2-1-2.
A 1-2. Thank you, Milady. The numbers then are 3 and 5. 2, 9 and 7. And the big one is, biggest of all, 100. Dropped. And a tiny target of 112.
Yeah, 112 is the clock. Strange how you can get difficult letters and easy numbers. It's very odd. Well, what have you got, right?
Yeah, 112.
I think you've both got that.
112.
Well, I'm sure you both got that, but we have to go through the motions here. Roz, can you just run it by Carol?
100 plus 9 plus 3.
Oh, amazing.
You didn't write that down. And what about you, Tim?
100 plus 7 plus 5.
Oh, you see. Controversial, Tim. Controversial.
Right, 10 points each for both of our players there. And we... we head to the countdown conundrum here, so fingers on the buzzers as we reveal today's countdown conundrum. Tim.
Messaging.
Messaging. Let's have a little look. That's what it is, messaging. He's getting better, and you head for your next week, the next one, I should say. Your next one is the Octochamp game, so how are you feeling about that? Good?
Yes.
Sadly, we're going to say cheerio to Roz. Tell your dad if ever needs another support act. I'll come and support him sometime if he needs that. Sadly, you're just going to get the goodie bag. I mean, you said you've got a three-year-old son?
Yes.
Three-year-old son?
And a five-year-old.
Yeah, and a five-year-old. Well, yeah. They give them the goodie bag. They can play with it. So we wish them both luck. We'll be seeing Tim for the next round, which is your important round. Well done so far. In the meantime, I haven't really asked you, because last week we had James Whittaker with us, who was royal correspondent for the press. Mm. But you did it for ITN, didn't you?
I did, yeah. 6 years, yes.
What does that entail? You actually go and meet the royals?
Yes, quite a bit. Said to me, the actual words were, Mick, we need a new royal correspondent. And I said, yes, I agree with you, because the present one was doing it was rubbish. And then I said, you don't mean me? And he said, yes, I do. And my quick think was, right, what can I ask in return? And I said, can I go on the trips? Because they go abroad a lot, yeah. You know, they used to in those days particularly. And he said, yes, all right. So I travelled the world with them, which was no complaint.
Having, you know, that job where you're going to talk to them, what was the most memorable interview or chat with any of them that sticks in the mind?
Oh, I think that's easy. I was I think it was 1997, 98, I think it was. The Queen went to South Africa for the first time when Nelson Mandela had been made president. South Africa had rejoined the Commonwealth, and the Queen was there, and one beautiful afternoon, anybody who's been to Cape Town, no, Table Mountain on one side, the sea on the other, and I was standing on the deck of Britannia talking to the Queen.
Not bad, eh?
And I remember thinking, well, you did quite well, lad, didn't you?
Oh, a very interesting story, Nick. Must have been a good feeling. And get some more good feeling with another countdown. Join us tomorrow. See you. Bye.